13 students, 7 countries, 1 question. Does microplastic, tiny particles floating in the oceans, harm marine animals? The young researchers participate in the GAME program. GAME stands for Global Approach by Modular Experiments. But it means much more: international cooperation, self-responsibility, and an excellent foundation for a career in marine sciences. The global approach has several benefits. On the one hand, we are able to have a global perspective. On the other hand, students from different cultures learn to deal with other ways of thinking and working. They form a network and stay connected for quite some time. That means we are creating a community of scientists that is able to switch between different working standards, look at different scales, and communicate across cultures. The game starts in northern Germany. At GEOMAR, Helmholtz-Zentrum for Ocean Research Kiel, the young scientists define their research questions. Then the team set out to Brazil, Chile, Indonesia, Japan, Madeira, Mexico, and Wales. Indonesia, an emerging country with ambitions and problems. As there is no public waste disposal system, the major part of the litter is dumped onto streets or into rivers and the sea. What happens if marine organisms take up small plastic particles with their food? Nisa and Sinja join fishermen who collect green mussels in Jakarta Bay. The students take part of the catch to the laboratory at Bogor University. In their aquaria, the two students keep mussels and sea cucumbers at 5 different pollution scenarios for 2 months. Sinja also runs another experiment, living and working in the Far East. Daily life was different from what I was used to, but after I had settled in, everything worked really well, especially because I was not on my own, but had a partner from Indonesia who helped me a lot in all aspects of life. Brazil. Beautiful beaches, turquoise waters, bright sunshine. A paradise, at first sight. Bruno has been supporting game students at Niterói University for a couple of years. Now he fully participates in the program. Our work is really important. We need to explain to society that microplastics are really dangerous. Microplastics are a big problem, but people don't know very much about it. They don't understand that we pollute our marine environment. For example, sometimes I see people throwing away plastic in the streets. Bruno and Malin decided to work with the fiddler crab. Catching these animals at low tide in a mangrove forest wasn't too easy. They are really fast, so it's kind of a challenge to catch them. We poked into one end of the crab's burrows with a stick to chase them out and caught them with a small bucket on the other side.
Successful!
Some of the crabs seem to suffer from the microplastic pollution, but further studies are needed to provide clarity. Madeira, the island of eternal spring. Here is where Laura and Lisa live and work for half a year. Locals and tourists enjoy the sea and the sun. Laura and Lisa are trying to find sea cucumbers for their experiment. These animals live on organic material which they collect from the seafloor. By doing this, they can take in plastic particles and accumulate pollutants from the plastic in their bodies. In a joint effort, the two students investigate how the sea cucumbers react. Lisa was a great partner to work with. When I was not able to make a decision, Lisa did. And in the areas where she was a bit weaker, I could go ahead. When working in a team, you notice the differences between characters. You are stronger in some aspects, while the other person has other strengths. So you can complement and learn from each other. That is kind of a challenge, but in the end, it feels just great to work in a team. And how do mussels from whales react to microplastic pollution? Ina set up her experiment all by herself using soda bottles, tubes, pipes, and wooden frames. With this system, she is able to handle more than 60 mussels distributed over 6 different experimental scenarios at the same time.
Alles aufzubauen, rauszufinden.
To set up everything and to see how it grows. You start with a small step and then you take another small step. And in the end, these small steps add up to a really big project that works. On 2 dates during the course of her experiment, Ina tests how fast mussels take up their food. This allows her to assess the mussels' health. After half a year, the students reunite in Kiel. At the Institute of Toxicology at Kiel University, they analyze tissue samples from their experiments. We observed that in general, the filter feeders were more susceptible to exposure to microplastic particles. This is presumably due to the different ways in which the two groups of organisms interact with the plastic. In some animals, we found increased concentrations of the fluorinthine. Another very important result of the studies, environmental conditions and further local stressors seem to influence how susceptible animals are to microplastic pollution. Heat stress or the lack of oxygen might already impair the organism's performance. If larger amounts of plastic add to this, the situation can become threatening. With this finding, the 12th Game Project contributes significantly to our understanding of changes in the oceans. The students present their results in Kiel, Oldenburg, Hamburg, Rostock and Bremen and deeply impress the game program sponsors and trustees. I am glad that young people from different countries worldwide get together in teams and cooperate in their research. They develop intense relationships across cultures. Of course, doing science is the most important aspect, but I think they also learn how to interact and cooperate, personal and cultural understanding. And these things are as valuable as the excellent research they conduct. It's not just about scientific cooperation. It's not just about personal development. It's particularly the media training and the workshops on communicating science that make the training so comprehensive. That's what makes GAME so different from other programs.
GAME is an exciting project. It supports global thinking, it supports international collaboration, and it will provide new fascinating insights into the oceans.
While the participants of the GAME Project 2014 are busy writing up their final reports and theses, a new generation of students sets out to track the consequences of global change. And the coordinators are busy with planning future game projects.
Also natürlich machen wir mit diesen Großkarten.
We will continue working on large-scale ecological problems, but we would also like to expand the game principle to other disciplines that are interested in global issues.
Auch an weltweiten Fragestellungen interessiert sind.
One interdisciplinary question we are already preparing is the public perception of the marine environment. How the ocean is perceived, for example, in Indonesia, in Brazil, and in Norway.
Wie in Norwegen zum Beispiel.